I'm trying to figure out, I'm trying to understand whether it's okay that I am a hermit in an urban landscape who doesn't want to do anything. And this is also true. I have a back brace, like a Velcro thing, and sometimes you can buy them at Walgreens and they cinch it. It's like you may have seen the commercial for making your waist real small. It's really just a back brace. If you put it on far too tight, walk at a rigorous pace, and crush up your anti-inflammatory pills in a dust and put them on your cigarettes and smoke them. I'm not proud of this. You will get whacked. Like, you've got to be creative when you can't drink anymore and everybody in your peer group was at your intervention. You have to find many other ways around this. And that's one of them, if you want to go that route. I'm not advising that you do it. And I'm, again, not bragging or boasting or being, you know,
no one thinks you're bragging.
Being glib is a young man's game. Being glib is a young man's game. And I'm not doing that. I'm just being honest with you. That my life.
Hyperventilating and then smoking Advil, basically. Are we talking about like ibuprofen or Aleve? Or?
No. It's called carisoprobidol.
Oh, it's like a prescription
anti. It's a prescription anti. I also have arthritis in my hand now.
That's some real deal stuff, I bet.
So I crush it and I sprinkle all the dust on my cigarettes.
Uh huh.
And then I take a cinch it from Walgreens. And I put it on under my shirt too tight, and then I go walk. I get my arms into it. Brisk. You will really feel something. Before you feel nauseous, there's a window. There's a window. And don't eat anything, because that'll kill it. You can't have eaten anything prior. You have to have an empty stomach to do this correctly. And I don't know if these things are okay. Is it okay to just accept your nature and say, oh yes, just your whole day can be just small tasks of finding cords for your jewelry and stopping at Walgreens to get another back brace and things of this nature. Because like I said, this has been going on for 28 years.
You've done a lot of stuff over 28 years.
I haven't. I live every day like it's my first. I take it easy. I honestly don't use every minute.
No. I'm not saying use every minute to like, but you've done a lot in 28 years. Like you've done some. It doesn't even matter how you look at it.
I sort of.
Sounds like you're a little harsh on yourself.
I'm not at all. At all.
Point proven.
I'm not being harsh. I've said nothing that is not untrue, and I don't think I'm being harsh on myself.
You said that in 28 years you haven't done a ton.
No. Well, which is true. Have I run with the bulls in Pamplona? I don't want to, but I haven't. Have I? You know
okay,
what I mean?
Okay, you're one flight away from having done a ton.
You should go do this. You should do this. I don't want to.
All right.
I really don't want to.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I don't.
Well, not wanting to is perfectly reasonable.
It's the same reason I don't get physicals or go to doctors. I don't look for trouble. I don't want to know. Whatever it is, leave it. I don't do self-checks of any kind, and I've never seen Breaking Bad. While we're admitting things, I've never seen Breaking Bad. But I don't do. And when I moisturize, it's so gingerly, because I don't want to feel anything below the surface. And with my deodorant, it's like hot potato. Just because if I were to find something, I know me well enough to know that I'm not gonna beat this thing, man. I'm not gonna beat this thing. It's not me.